Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how you can connect Python with MySQL and run queries using code. So I'll be showing you the entire thing from how to download and install Python and MySQL Workbench and also how to connect both. So let's get started. So just go to Google and search for download Python. You'll be getting the first link, python.org. Just click that. And here we'll be having the latest version of Python, which is the 3.12.0. This is the upgraded version. Just click on this and your download will be getting started. So it is about 25 MB in size, so it gets downloaded in a flash. Just open it and you'll be getting the Python setup over here. I want you to check both of these options, okay? You need to also check this add python.exe to the path. If you don't do this, you'll be getting some errors when you run your Python program. So just check both these things and just click on this install now. Just click on yes and you'll be getting setup was successful. Just click on close. Now just go to search and type for environment variables. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables. Just click on open and here you need to click on environment variables, and under user variables here you'll be having something called as path. Click that and click on edit. So you'll be having this two Python paths automatically added over here. So if you don't have this path, I would recommend you to add these paths, okay? So now we are done. Just close everything. Let's just go to command prompt and we need to run the command python hyphen hyphen version. So here you can see I'm getting Python 3.12.0, which means that we have successfully configured. And in case if you want to run any Python program immediately, what you can do is you can just go to search and type idle. You'll be getting this idle Python 3.12 app. Just click on open and here you need to go to file. You need to click on new file and this will give you an interface where you can run any Python program. So I'll just go with print hello. That's it. I'll just save this. You can save it anywhere, something, and for running this just click on run and I'll be getting the output over here. So just go to Google and type MySQL. You'll be getting the first link as mysql.com. Just click this and in this website here you'll be having this download option. Just click on that and in the downloads you need to just scroll down and here you'll be having this MySQL community GPL downloads. Just click that and here we will be having so many MySQL things, but we need to go for MySQL installer for Windows. Alright, so here also we'll be having Workbench. Please don't click that. You need to click MySQL installer for Windows. Select that and you'll be having this MySQL installer 8.0.34, which is the latest version, and just select Microsoft Windows. And if you scroll down here you'll be having a web community one and you'll be having the installer community. So you need to install the MySQL installer community and not the web one. Just click on the download and you need to click on this no thanks, just start my download. Yeah, so the download has begun. It's about 331 MB in size, so just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just click on open. So you'll be getting this MySQL installer type thing and by default you'll be having this server only option enabled. Alright, so you need to click on custom. Alright, and you need to click on next and here we will be having the list of products that are offered by MySQL. So I'll just click on this plus icon nearby MySQL servers and here you'll be having this MySQL server. Click on the plus again and click on the plus again in MySQL Server 8.0 and you need to just select this thing, okay? MySQL Server 8.0.34, it needs to get highlighted in blue and you need to click on this green color arrow. So once you do this, you'll be getting that name over here, which means that this particular product or software is going to get installed on your system. Alright, this is a standard thing, don't ignore this, okay? Next thing, we need to go into applications and here we will be having the most important thing, which is MySQL Workbench, which is like a GUI tool for MySQL. It's super important. All right, same thing, just click the plus icon, click that blue color enabled and click the green color right arrow. You'll be getting there. And I think MySQL shell is also important. Same thing, click that and green color arrow. And you also have MySQL router, which is not most commonly used. I have never touched that thing. And you also have the documentation and examples, which are also not needed. So I think these three are pretty much the standard things that everybody use. So I'm good with this. These three things, please install these three. And just click on next. And you'll be getting the same over here, which is having the status ready to install. And once we click on execute, here it says, right, the installation of these packages will begin. So let me just now click on execute. So here you can see, right, it's installing and the progress appears over here. So once all the packages are installed, you'll be getting this green color mark and you'll be having the status as complete. So just click on next and ready to configure. Yeah, this is fine. Just click on next. And here you'll be having the port and the development computer. So just don't touch this stuff. Okay, just click on next. Too strong password encryption for authentication. Yeah, this is fine. Just click on next. And here you need to be super, super careful. Okay. You need to enter your MySQL root password. So I would really recommend you to like save this password somewhere. It's really a hard process to reset this, and it may even like require you to uninstall and reinstall your MySQL setup. So I would basically, you know, have a familiar password. That's the thing. So I'll just enter my familiar password over here, or you can just have it somewhere else. So yeah, we can, it says weak, I don't care. I will just click on next. And yeah, standard account, this is fine. Service name, everything is fine. Just click on next. Yeah, grant full permission for the user. Yeah, this is also fine. I'll just click on next. And these are the steps that are going to take place now. I'll just click on execute and our installation will begin now. After some time, you'll be getting the configuration for MySQL server was successful. Click finish to continue. I'll just click on finish. Yeah, I'll just click next again. So here you'll be having two options: start MySQL workbench after setup, start MySQL shell after setup. I'll just click on finish and I'll just enable these two to make sure that they have installed properly. So I'll just click on finish. So this is the MySQL shell over here and this is MySQL workbench. So first let us finish off MySQL workbench, then later we will go to MySQL shell. All right. So first thing what you need to do is you need to just go to services and you need to click on open. And in the services, you need to have this thing, MySQL 80. Yeah. So this needs to be running and I would recommend you to set it up as automatic. So in the properties, you need to have this as startup type as automatic. So if you don't have it automatic, you need to like every time go here, turn it on manually. So I would recommend you to have this as automatic startup type. So I'm going to just select this and click on automatic. Yeah. So this is running now. So this is fine. So now let's go to our MySQL workbench and you need to click on this plus thing. And here you'll be having this connection name. So I'll just type my first connection, something like that. And you need to just click on OK. That's it. You'll be having the connection over here. Just double click it. And here you need to enter the password that you gave during your MySQL setup. So I'll just enter that password and I'll just click on OK. So this will take me in and here I can run any MySQL query. So let me just now first go and create a database and make sure that the command is working fine. So let me just go and type create database. I will just go with the name, new name. This is going to be the name of my database, something. I'll just run it. So I'm getting here a green mark, which means that this query has been executed successfully. So I'll just go with something, show databases. Yeah, this is the command to display the list of databases. So we will be getting these things. And I know what you are thinking, the font size is very small. So to increase the font size, what you can do is you need to go to edit and you'll be having the preferences. And inside preferences, you'll be having this fonts and colors. The next one to modeling, just click fonts and colors and basically just, you know, change everything to like 30 or 40. Yeah, just change it because I think the size of the fonts throughout MySQL is small. So, you know, better change everything to a decent number and just click on OK. Yeah, and it won't get changed. So let me just now close my connection. And if I just now again go into my connection, just enter it. So now you can see the font size has drastically improved a lot. So this is good. Now we're done with our MySQL Workbench setup. So now let's go and do the MySQL shell setup. So if I just now go to my command prompt, and if I just now type MySQL --- version, I'll be getting this MySQL is not recognized. Okay, so for that, let's fix it now. So let me just now close this, and you need to go to the folder where you have installed MySQL. All right, so by default it's going to be C, program files, and here you'll be having MySQL, and inside that you need to go to MySQL server 8.0. it's not shell, it's not workbench, it's server, and inside that you'll be having this bin. Click that, and you need to basically just copy this thing, copy it fully. All right, and in case if you it's hard for you to find this path, what you can do is you can basically just go and search for MySQL. You'll be getting this MySQL workbench. Just click on open file location, right click it again, open file location, just go back a folder, you'll be having this MySQL server 8.0, and inside this bin we will be back to the normal path where we were began. So just copy this path till bin under server 8.0. after copying it, go to search and type for environment. You'll be getting this option called as edit the system environment variables. Just click on open, and in this you'll be having this environment variables thing. Click that, and under system variables just click on path, and you need to click on edit, and in this you will be having an option called as new. Click that, and you need to just paste this path. Be careful, it's MySQL server 8.0 and till bin. Just click on OK everywhere here also, and in case if you are having your command prompt open, just close and reopen it again, otherwise you won't be getting the changes affected. So I'll just go again to search CMD, I'll just zoom it, and if I type MySQL --- version, so here you can see just a moment ago I was getting some kind of error, but now I'm getting the version, which is the latest version that we have installed right now. So after this, in order for us to run MySQL commands through our terminal, what you can do is you need to type MySQL -u space root -p. Just hit enter, and here you need to enter the password that you gave installed MySQL server and workbench. So that's the reason why I told you that password is like super important. Without that password you cannot do anything here. So just enter that password, and here you can see now I'm getting this MySQL command prompt thing, like a shell where I can run MySQL queries. So I'll just go with show databases, just hit enter. So here you can see that I'm having this new name database, which is the database that I created a moment ago. So as I told you, this workbench is super useful tool. Just a GUI basically, you know, shows the names and rows present in a column in a much more visual and appealing way. So yeah, both have the same data at the end of the day. So now we are done setting up both Python and our MySQL workbench database. So now let's just go and write the code for connecting our Python code with this database over here. So for this, just go to search and type idle, and if you have any other text editor you can use that. I will just use the default Python one. Open it, and here you'll be having at the top called as file. Click that and just select new file. So you can just save it. I'll just click on save as, and you can just type anything. Just save this first. Now we are good, and in case if you want to change the font style, just click on options, configure idle. Here you can change the font size, and just click on apply and okay. Yeah, so this is fine. So now let's just begin our coding. So before that, we need to install one particular Python package. Okay, just go to Google and type pip MySQL Python connector. You'll be getting this first one. This is going to be pip install MySQL --connector -python. Just copy this, or else you can just see the video and type this. All right, and now go to search and open command prompt, and just paste this command and hit enter. That's it. This particular package will be getting installed. That's it. So now again go to our Python file, and we need to import this. So it's going to be import mysql.connector. So this is going to be the only package that we'll be importing, and next is going to be the connection variable. with this particular statement, we will be able to directly connect with our MySQL Workbench. So it's going to be CYN, let it be the connection variable, equal to MySQL dot connector dot connect, and within circular bracket we need to specify some information over here. First is the user. The user is going to be, in my case, I have mentioned the username as root. If you remember, in my MySQL Workbench, I have given my connection username as root. So if you have given something else, you need to give that username. By default, it's going to be root. So that's good over here, root. And next thing is going to be the host. Here we are just using local host, so it's going to be host equal to, within single quote, just type local host, comma. Next is going to be the database name, so it's going to be database equal to, and here we need to specify the database that we just created now. So in our case, it's going to be this new name. I'll just copy this, go here and paste it within single quotes. Next one is going to be the password. So for password, we are not writing the full keyword, so it's going to be passwd. So this is going to be the password, and just enter the password for your MySQL account. Okay, so I will enter mine. So now we are good with the connection variable. So let's just go and print this now. So for just making sure that we are not getting any errors, let's just print this variable. So I'm saving it, and for running this, it's going to be run, and click on run module. So here you can see we are not getting any errors. So now what we can do is, let's just go and create a table inside this database named new name. So I already have some tables inside this database. So if I just, you know, go inside tables, I'm having these many tables already created. So I'll just create a new table inside this database with the help of Python code. All right. So for doing that, what you need to do is, just come to the next line. We need to create a something called as cursor, and only with the help of this cursor object, we will be able to directly execute MySQL queries in Python. So I will create that cursor variable. So let me name it as cur equal to our connection variable name dot, we will be using the cursor function. So it's going to be cursor function. That's it. So now we can write our MySQL queries directly inside it. So it's going to be something like this, our cursor variable name dot execute, and within circular brackets, and inside that we need to have double quotes, and inside this we will be specifying our normal MySQL queries. So I'm having here a simple query to create a table. So this is just a create table customers. I'm just going to create this table now. So I'll just copy and paste it inside this. So this is just a create table in SQL, create table. This is my table name, and this is going to be my two columns. One is column named name, another column name is ID, and one column is going to have the data type as varchar or string, and another column is going to have the data type as integer. So this is going to be my thing. And final thing is going to be the commit function. So for MySQL to replicate and reflect all these changes, we need to add this final commit function. So for that, it's going to be our connection name, and be careful over here, this is our connection variable name and not our cursor variable name. Okay, so this is the first variable that we have used. It's going to be dot commit and a function. That's it. So now let me just save it, and here you can see, if this code runs perfectly, we will be having here a table named customers, because we don't have that particular table at the moment, right? And if this code is a success, we will be getting that in the output. So I'll just click on run, run module. So we won't be getting anything over here, but if I go to my MySQL Workbench, and if I just now refresh this, here you can see I'm having a table called as customers. And if I just go into the information of the table, and if I go to columns, here you can see I'm having two columns named ID and name, type int and varchar, which are the same thing that we have specified over here, which means that we have successfully created a table by using our Python code in MySQL. So that's the video, guys. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of programming videos in Python, C, C++, Java, and lot of MySQL queries. So, and AI videos also. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.